Hello my dear students, today I am going to make a video on hybridization. Actually hybridization is a very important concept, we know, from inorganic compounds, coordination compounds also come under inorganic compounds, but the discussion of hybridization on coordination compounds is totally different and organic compounds. So in today's lecture I am going to talk about the finding of hybridization in inorganic compounds and organic compounds in two different model questions, and there is a separate video on hybridization of coordination compounds. Okay, let's see today's class. In this I am going to give you some tricks for finding hybridization. Actually there are two model questions in hybridization. That is, first model is when molecular formula is given, on the basis of given information you have to solve the question. So in some questions molecular formula is given, in some questions structural formula is given. So in two different cases how to deal this hybridization, let's see now. So I am going to talk about case one. That is, molecular formula is given. So if molecular formula is given, then you simply do one thing, you find total number of valence electrons, count total number of valence electrons of that molecule. It means the number of valence electrons in central atom and that inside atom as well, and central plus side total. And if this value comes out to be less than or equal to 8, then divide by 2. If it is more than 8 but up to 56, divide by 8. If it is more than 56, then divide by 18. So these are just tricks. Okay, by memorizing these tricks you cannot solve the question unless you practice. You have to practice the question. So SO2, actually I have collected these questions from your JEE previous year questions. Many examples are there, but some examples I have collected from JEE advanced examination. So in JEE advanced examination the SO2 question came more than one time, different questions, methyl carbocation, CO2 lactate. Okay, these are J advanced questions. So how to calculate hybridization? When molecular formula is given, all of you strictly follow some guidelines. Actually when you are given any molecule except hydrogen, all other atoms, central atom, side atoms also participate in hybridization, no doubt. But when we are given a molecular formula, it means you are asked to find the hybridization of central atom only, not side atoms. So this trick is exclusively for molecular formulae, and when molecular formula is given it means you are asked to calculate hybridization or number of lone pair and bond pairs at central atom only, not side atoms. If structural formula is given, then you can find hybridization of central atom and side atoms as well. Hydrogen never participates in hybridization because that has only one valence electron. And in any molecule, hydrogen or fluorine can never act as central atoms. They cannot form more than two bonds. So that's why hydrogen and fluorine can never act as central atoms. If you have any confusion in finding central atom, no need to confuse. Hydrogen or fluorine can never act as central atoms. And when you are given any molecular species, whether it is a neutral, cation or anion, you see which is less electronegative atom. That should be the central atom. If still you have any confusion, then you see the atom which is present in less number, that should be the central atom. So in this, sulfur is less electronegative, so SO2 is there. So sulfur has 6 valence electrons, 2 oxygens are there, 2 into 6, total answer is coming 18. Total number of electrons you have to divide by 8. Divide like this, 2 8s are 16, 2 is the remainder, 2 is again less than 8, you have to again divide by 2. So 2 plus 1, 3 is the answer. So 3 means which type of hybridization? SP2. How to come to know, sir? Very easy. If your answer is 2, type of hybridization is SP, 3 SP2, 4 SP3, 5 SP3D, 6 SP3D2, 7 SP3D3, like this. No confusion now, because these are your answer 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, whatever it may be. So from your answer you can identify the type of hybridization. Again, this is not a difficult task for you. You see 2 s power 1 p power 1, add power simply 1 plus 2 3, 1 plus 3 4, 1 plus 3 plus 1 5. You can logically understand this concept. So our answer is 3 here. So well, it should be sp2 and hybridization is over. Suppose you are asked to find number of lone pairs and bond pairs at the central atom also. Then how to find? This is also very easy, because there is no need of any formula to find number of bond pairs. That is clearly visible at the central atom. How many oxygens are attached? 2 means 2 bond pairs are there. 2 bond pairs. And what is your answer? 3. 3 minus 2, 1 lone pair. Okay, so your answer minus number of bond pairs that is visible from the given molecular formula, that difference will give number of lone pairs. Like this, we can solve other questions as well. But strictly remember, whatever I am talking about hybridization, lone pair, bond pair, this is exclusively for central atom, not for side atoms. So CH3 plus, carbon has 4 valence electrons, 3 hydrogens have 3 and 1 positive charge. Positive charge always represents electron deficiency. 1 unit of positive charge is there, then subtract 1 electron, your answer is coming 6, then divide by 2, answer is coming 3. sp2 hybridization, and 3 bond pairs are clearly visible, there is no lone pair. So that has regular geometry, triangular planar, that you know from VSCPR theory. Without knowing VSCPR theory, you cannot predict the geometry or shape. That tabular form given in NCERT is very, very important from VSCPR theory. Suppose these many lone pairs, these many bond pairs, what should be shape? And 0 lone pair, only bond pair, what should be geometry? That you have to memorize. Actually, when you solve number of questions, automatically you can memorize. So CO2 is there, the central atom is carbon, 4 plus 2 into oxygen has 6 valence electrons. The total answer is coming 16. You can directly cancel 8. 2 is the answer sp, and 2 oxygens, 2 answer, no lone pair. Let's talk about PCl3 now. And phosphorus is the central atom, 5 valence electrons, 3 into chlorine, 7. Each halogen has 7 valence electron. 26 is the answer. Divide by 8, 2. Okay, 1, 2 is 2. I mean, generally you have to divide like this till you get the remainder 0 or 1. If you get the remainder 1, then you can add this value in number of hybrid orbitals. Remainder is 0, there is no problem. If remainder is 1, then 3 plus 1 plus 1, you add like that. Okay, so 3 plus 1, 4. Answer is 4. In PCl3, phosphorus is sp3 hybridized, and 3 chlorine atoms are visible. It means 3 bond pairs and 4 minus 3, 1 lone pair. Very, very simple. Okay, so don't ever use any formula to calculate number of lone pairs and bond pairs. Through hybridization trick, you can find number of bond pairs and lone pairs as well. Well, ClO2 minus, chlorine is the central atom, no doubt. Okay, chlorine is present in less number, no doubt chlorine is less electronegative than oxygen. So ClO2 minus it is. Chlorine being halogen, 7 valence electrons, 2 oxygens. Now 1 unit of negative charge is there, means add 1 electron. 20 is coming. Divide by 8. Now divide by 2, because it is less than 8, na? Because when you divide any number by 8, you will get less than 8 as remainder. So less than 8 means again you have to divide by 2. Is this one. 2s are 4, 0. 2 plus 2, what? 4, na? It means sp3 hybridized. तो फोर इज द आंसर. तो फोर मीन्स sp3 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन एंड क्लोरीन हैज ओनली टू ऑक्सीजन अटैच. इट मीन्स टू बॉन्ड पेयर्स आर विजिबल एंड रेस्ट टू आर लोन पेयर्स, एंगुलर, बेंट और वी शेप, वॉट एवर इट मे बी. ओके, नाउ लेट्स गो अहेड. NO2-, नेक्स्ट वन इज NO3-, NO2-, नाइट्रोजन हैज 5 वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, 2 ऑक्सीजन हैव 2 × 6 NO2+, ओके, 2 × 6 एंड वन पॉजिटिव चार्ज इज देयर, मैन सब्ट्रैक्ट वन इलेक्ट्रॉन. व्हाट इज द आंसर? 2 × 6 = 12 16 मीन्स डायरेक्टली यू कैन डिवाइड बाय 8. 2 इज द आंसर. तो इन NO2- नाइट्रोजन हैज sp हाइब्रिडाइजेशन एंड देर इज नो लोन पेयर, रेगुलर ज्योमेट्री, दैट इज लीनियर. दिस टाइम NO3- given, नाइट्रोजन हैज 5 वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, 3 ऑक्सीजन, 3 × 6, 1 यूनिट ऑफ नेगेटिव चार्ज, ऐड 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन. 3 × 6 = 18, 24 / 8, आंसर इज कमिंग 3. इट मीन्स sp2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन. नाइट्रोजन हैज sp2 हाइब्रिडाइजेशन एंड नाइट्रोजन इज अटैच्ड टू 3 ऑक्सीजन एटम्स, मीन्स 3 एंड आंसर इज 3. देर इज नो लोन पेयर. Now ammonium cation is another J advanced question. Nitrogen has 5 valence electrons, 4 hydrogens have 4 valence electrons, 1 unit of positive charge, means deduct 1 electron. Answer is coming 8. Simply you are getting 4. Nitrogen is central atom, 4 and 4 bond pairs, sp3 and no lone pair, regular tetrahedron. You must know about tetrahedron, because without knowing tetrahedron, planar and linear geometries, you cannot understand many organic topics. Okay. So I think from these you can solve hybridization, number of lone pairs and bond pairs in these questions. I think you can solve, no problem. I am going to explain case 2. This is also a standard model from hybridization. Already questions came in JEE mains, advanced and NEET examinations. Well, in case 2, second model question, in this model question, suppose we are given structural formula. Structural formula is given. Then how to solve this question? It is very easy. Simply you count number of electron pairs. Number of electron pairs, it means number of bond pairs plus number of lone pairs, because structural formula will be given to you. So from this bond pair you can calculate. Okay, so if total number of electron pairs comes out to be 2, hybridization must be sp3 is sp2, just like previous case. 5 means sp3d. 7 means sp3d3. Okay, so now how to solve this? Let me take some questions from JEE advanced examination. Okay, let's solve some questions. There is a question in that there were 4 options. In every option, carbon atom was highlighted and the question was, find the highlighted carbon atom where sp3 hybridization is there. Means among these 4 options, actually 4 options, 4 carbons. In every option, 1 carbon is highlighted. We have to find the highlighted carbon which is sp3 hybridized in nature. This was the question. sp3 hybridization was given. So how to calculate? You see, in this is the highlighted carbon. 1, 2, and 3 bond pairs are there, because as per VSCPR theory, clearly we know that if a double bond or a triple bond, I mean a multiple bond is present, that should be treated as a single bond pair. That is also called super pair. Okay, so only one bond pair, three bond pairs are there, it means it is sp2. Now you see 1 2 3 bond pairs, again sp2, 1 2 3 4 bond pairs, sp3, this one 1 2 3 bond pairs, again sp2. So your answer is this is a JEE advanced question. Like that, one more question is there from JEE advanced examination. So there is a reaction between BF3 and ammonia, and after the reaction between these two, you have to find the type of hybridization of nitrogen and boron both. Okay, so first you see boron has vacant d orbital, it is a Lewis acid, it is a Lewis base electron rich. So electron rich one can donate lone pair to electron deficient boron, because boron is a 13th group element. Even in excited state it has one vacant p orbital, it is electron deficient, electron rich. Between electron rich and electron deficient, we know day 2 bond formation takes place. Okay, day 2 bond formation. For clarity, for fluorine is written left side and nothing. Now day 2 bond formation takes place. Before this reaction, boron is attached to 3 fluorine atoms, it means 3 bond pairs. There is no chance of lone pair at 13th group element. So 3 bond pairs means total electron pairs is 3, it is sp2. And you see 3 bond pairs, 1 lone pair clearly visible, it is sp3. After completion of reaction, you see boron is attached to 3 fluorine atoms as usual, but now an additional bond is also present, because once day 2 bond formation takes place, it is also a type of covalent bond. This bond is common to both boron and nitrogen, but now boron has 3+1, 4 bond pairs, I mean 4 electron pairs, it is sp3, it is still sp3, means we can understand that during the formation of coordinate covalent bond, the hybridization of donor atom never changes, but that of acceptor atom always changes. This is a straight away NCERT question, exercise question asked in JEE advanced examination. So that's why I always say that don't ever underestimate NCERT textbook. NCERT even theory questions are also very, very important. Exercise questions, in-text questions, and the theoretical information is also very, very important. Well, let us solve one more question and I will conclude this. There is a question related to beryllium chloride. Beryllium chloride exists in 3 forms: monomer, dimer, and polymer. Okay. So we need to find the state of hybridization of beryllium in all 3 states. This is vapor phase. This is also vapor phase. Okay. It is monomer, a discrete molecule. It exists about 1200 Kelvin, less than 1200 Kelvin. This is exclusively in solid state. So beryllium chloride exists as monomer, dimer, and polymer. Monomer in vapor phase above this temperature, dimer in vapor phase below this temperature, polymer in solid state. Solid BeCl2 exists as a polymer like this. Okay, now you see carefully, what is the type of hybridization of beryllium? Because structural formula is visible. Beryllium has 2 valence electrons only, and that is already in 2 bond formation. 2 covalent bonds are formed, and there is no chance for lone pair, because beryllium, it has just 2 valence electrons. 2 bonds are already formed. So 2 bond pairs, sp hybridization. this beryllium, you see 1-2 additional bond, day 2 bond is formed by the donation of lone pair from chlorine. This is clear that beryllium is sp2 hybrid. 1-2-3, okay, 3 bond pairs. Now in polymer you see 1-2-3-4, means day 2 bond is also a single bond. So single bond means single bond pair. So total 4 bond pairs are there. Beryllium is sp3 hybridized. From the structural formula you can easily identify the type of hybridization of that atom, any atom, not only beryllium. You see, suppose you are given ethyl alcohol and you are asked to calculate hybridization of oxygen. Can't you calculate? You see, oxygen 2 bond pairs, and out of 6 valence electrons, 2 already in bond formation, so 4 in the form of 2 lone pairs. So 2 plus 2, 2 bond pair, 2 lone pair, total 4 electron pairs, sp3 hybridization. Single bonded carbon is already sp3 hybridized as per the knowledge we know. So this is again sp3. Okay, for central atom and side atoms also you can calculate type of hybridization. You are given methyl cyanide. Can't you calculate hybridization of carbon and nitrogen? You see, this is the expanded formula. Carbon is attached to 4 bond pairs, sp3, 1 plus 1, 2 bond pairs, sp, nitrogen, 1 bond pair and 1 lone pair, sp. But the calculation of hybridization is not possible in case of molecular formula. When molecular formula is given, then the calculation of hybridization, number of lone pairs and bond pairs, is strictly applicable to the central atom. But when structural formula is given, you can calculate the hybridization of central atom as well as side atom. Okay, so for this you can take one more example like this. The dimer of ICl3, an interhalogen compound, we all know about this. Okay, dimer is like this. Iodine has 7 valence electrons, so only 1-2-3 participated, means 2 lone pairs still exist. Now what is the type of hybridization of iodine? 1-2-3-4 bond pairs and 2 lone pairs, total 6 electron pairs, sp3d2. This one also has sp3d2, the dimer of ICl3. Generally in dimer formation, trick is very easy. Day 2 bond must be formed between two molecules. This is ICl3, this is ICl3. So how to fuse them? By forming day 2 bond, chlorine gives day 2 bond to iodine and chlorine gives day 2 bond to iodine. That is central atom. Central atoms accept lone pair and side atoms donate lone pair. So this is the dimer. After formation of dimer, you see iodine has total 6 electron pairs, sp3d2. Here also 6 electron pairs, sp3d2. Okay, so this is entire information regarding hybridization in inorganic compounds and organic compounds, and there is a separate discussion regarding hybridization in coordination compounds. Thank you very much for watching my video.